Could there be a legitimate purpose for this? Maybe, because normally in a lawsuit, you would want to trace the money. However, I think Mr. Hiroyuki Nakajima has maybe overreached a little bit here, or maybe he's a little bit premature, because this is the point where we get the identity, and then you file a lawsuit.
This is a community-supported legal education channel. Find out how you can support our mission at the links in the description below.
So, imagine you're YouTube. Because, you know, that's easy. We can just all put ourselves in YouTube shoes. Just, hey, I'm YouTube now. And you get this document. In re DMCA subpoena to YouTube. Hey, full stop, wait a second. We just saw something like this. Wasn't there one that we just saw in re DMCA subpoena to Reddit? Go watch those videos too if you want more of this. So this is the declaration of, I'm gonna try and get it, Hiroyuki Nakajima. I, Hiroyuki Nakajima, declare and testify as follows. I am an attorney duly licensed to practice law in Japan. I represent Shogakukan, please correct me if I've got that wrong, Inc., a Japanese corporation in the above entitled proceeding, and as such, I am authorized and qualified to make this declaration. Shogakukan is seeking a subpoena pursuant to 17 USC 512H. That is our DMCA subpoena statute in copyright law, to obtain information sufficient to identify the persons infringing its copyrighted works. The purpose for which the subpoena is sought is to obtain the identity of the alleged infringers. Such information will only be used for the purpose of protecting rights under the Copyright Act. I declare, under penalty of perjury, Hiroyuki Nakajima, attorney for Shogakukan. And so then what did they send? They sent this. And this is what I'm really concerned about. So this is to YouTube, subpoena to produce documents, information, or objects. Yes, this is what subpoena for federal subpoenas look like. This document has not seen court yet. I mean, it is filed in a court, but this document itself, for a DMCA subpoena, I think you do need to seek approval in court first. Generally speaking, you don't have to do that for sending federal subpoenas. So generally speaking, you wouldn't need to have this approved by a court, but here it's had to be approved by a court because of the requirements of 512H. So you are commanded to produce time, date, place set forth below electronically stored information in attachment 1 by June 12th, 10 a.m. And this is dated May 28th. Proof of service is something that we give back to the appropriate party. Usually, you know, return of service or something, you know, to prove that service was affected. And here is attachment 1. Request for production, all information sufficient to identify each infringer identified under the column. Let me see here, what column? Do we have a column? We have a column. Here's all the columns. So all of these infringers, there's 12 of them, it looks like. And any other users registered with YouTube.com who uploaded or posted infringing work specified under the con. Yes, except that's not how it works. Usually under DMCA law, you have to specify the specific work uploaded by a user at a specific link. And usually just saying, and any other works that are infringing, it doesn't count. So I'll cry foul there, but you know, let the judge deal with that. The infringers referred to in the foregoing A and B are collectively referred to as infringers. Exhibit A referred to herein is the notice dated May 22nd, which is attached to the subpoena. The information requested in the subpoena shall be from any and all sources, included but not limited to billing, administrative records that prove the following information used by each infringer related to whatever the Google account. Registered with the infringer's account on YouTube.com, along with a timestamp showing date, hour, minute, second from the time the user registration, time of user registration with any and all of the infringer's accounts and to date, any and all names, any and all addresses, telephone numbers, email addresses, logs of IP addresses used to upload or access the infringer's accounts, and any account numbers, credit card numbers, and the name of the financial institution which holds such accounts or issues such credit card numbers. That's what I'm concerned about right there. And then they sent this letter. Let's see what the letter is. To whom it may concern, I represent Shogakukan, the representative of two individual authors of copyrighted works. It's come to their attention that certain users of your services publish and post certain contents on your website. Exhibit A, etc. These works are not authorized. We demand you disable access and comply with our request. I declare the information is accurate. Hiroyuki Nakajima. So I actually don't have too much of a legal issue with the subpoena request itself. That's what 512H is for, is for requesting the identity of an infringer. So let's not get all up in arms and grab our pitchforks just because a subpoena was filed. However, look at what was requested. They requested credit card numbers and financial account numbers and the names of the institutions so that they can be, I guess, traced to those institutions. Now, could there be a legitimate purpose for this? Maybe, because normally in a lawsuit, you would want to trace the money. However, I think Mr. Hiroyuki, what's his name, Nakajima, has maybe overreached a little bit here, or maybe he's a little bit premature, because this is the point where we get the identity and then you file a lawsuit, not you get all of your discovery done and out of the way here. So either the court should maybe on its own strike the response part about the credit card numbers and account numbers. Maybe YouTube will file something in response to say, hey, this is too much. We want to quash the portion about credit card numbers and account numbers. Or if you are one of these 12 people, one of the privacy acts should trigger a notice to you before this subpoena is responded to on June 12th. So there should be more time than just June 12th. This is my speculation, so don't rely on this, but look for this. There should be more time than just June 12th, because a notice has to go to these 12 people so they can have a meaningful opportunity to respond in court. And if they didn't, then they can cry foul. So usually, at least in my line of work dealing with these subpoenas, you get more time. Sometimes 2 weeks, sometimes a couple of months. It's not really clearly established what the amount of time is, as long as it's a reasonable amount of time, which is somewhere around a couple of weeks to a couple of months. So these 12 people could respond with their own motions to quash or vacate or motions to strike or whatever their attorney, not me yet at least, that whatever their attorney agrees to file for them. They should be able to at least strike the part where they're asking for this account information, which is really overreaching, I think, in my humble opinion. Somebody else could argue with me, I'm sure. Maybe they need it for something, but normally you would get that in an actual lawsuit, which this isn't. And then in that lawsuit, you would have made out your claims against the individual defendants. Those individual defendants would be on notice of what the dispute is, and they would be then more informed as to whether they should be allowing or disputing your request for credit card numbers. Here is, I think, totally irrelevant, totally out of place, out of order, premature, and I think can be quashed. My humble opinion, though, somebody has to do it. What do you think of that? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Let us know what you think about Shogakuku's crap. I forgot what it was.
Shogakuku?
What was it? Shogakukin. There we go. Jesus Christ. That is our show. Thank you to our supporters for the month of June. This channel would not exist without your financial support. At the $50 level, thank you to John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Kyle Mudrock, Evie, Michael Pierce, Terry Crisp, Richard Fournier, Spirit Bear, Jan Negray, Daniel Perez, Aspernari, and Snorri Wizotsky. Thank you very much for your support at the $50 level. And thank you to the $5 plus supporters scrolling on the LED panel behind me and in the description below. You're all in the description below. And thank you very much for your support. We'll drop these stories about once per day, so you can expect that if you click that bell, you'll get about one Lawful Masses story per day. Otherwise, just click the subscription button and you'll get us in your feed from time to time, and hopefully you give us a click. So if you have any particular stories you'd like to see us do one of these analyses on or reviews on, give us drop us a line. You can find us at Twitter at Leonard J. French, or you can find us on Discord. I think there's a link in the description. And you can email us at business@lawfulmasses.com. I think Brandon checks that one. So anyway, thank you for joining me. I am Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney. I will see you in the videos that drop. Have a great second week of June. I love you all. Bye.